Well, hello, my name's Denny, and it's Saturday at 12:15. It's time for lunch. I'm in a hurry. I need to eat. What can I do for a quick lunch? I hope you're doing well. I want you to know that this is a pleasure for me to come and share this with you. I hope that it's something that you can benefit from. But one of the questions I often get is, what do I do if I'm in a hurry? And so I've opened up a can of jackfruit. Now, I have bought the jackfruit and cut it up. If you haven't ever done that, let me warn you, it is a chore. It is very sticky. You have to oil up your hands. You have to oil up your knife. And when you cut it, it's going to be a combination of slick and sticky. You could cut yourself real easy. Even doing this, I bought a can of jackfruit. I drained it. And it was mostly solid. Now, a lot of times it comes in, it looks a little shredded, like shredded chicken or shredded pork, and you just work it with your hands and continually shred it out. But this was mostly solid, so I chopped it up with a knife, and it has that same feature. It's sticky, and so you have to be very careful. When you wash and clean your knife, you have to be super careful, otherwise you can cut yourself. And so I chopped up this jackfruit, and there's a reason for it. I'm going to make barbecue sandwiches. Now, I'm not going to show you the whole process, but this is a quick meal. I've already chopped up my what looks like either shredded pork or shredded chicken, but it's jackfruit, and I'm going to put it in a pan with some barbecue sauce and some seasonings, and I'm going to make barbecue sandwiches. I'm going to top it with some coleslaw, with some vegan ranch, and it's going to be great. I'm going to have a great lunch. I put it on a whole wheat bun, I'll toast that bun, I'll have a quick lunch. I mean, it is quick. Now, I do want to talk about a couple of things. First off, there are things you can do to this recipe to make it your own or spice it up however you like. For example, I could add something like Frank's Red Hot, and I could make it a spicy barbecue. I could make it like a hot wing sandwich. Hot wing and then the ranch coleslaw would be a great combination. I could add sriracha and soy sauce, and I could give it more of an Asian barbecue flair. You know, when you're cooking the jackfruit, sometimes it might dry out, or you might want to soak it and give it a little extra flavor. One of the things that pit masters and barbecue chefs have used for years is apple juice. Now, instead of using apple juice that has sugar all in it, one of the things that you could do is just chop up some apples. So here's some green apples that I chopped up, and I'm going to add them to this. This is about a third of an apple and one can of jackfruit. And this green apple is going to give a little tartness, but also a little flavor and bite to the jackfruit without adding the liquid of the applesauce. Now, the apple has sugar too, but I don't want any added sugars. This one does not have added sugars, but still, instead of using the apple juice itself, I'm going to use the apple. So I'll have an apple and jackfruit barbecue sandwich with coleslaw. It's going to be good. Now, as far as seasonings go, I've made a rub here, and I'm going to share that rub with you. And what I'm doing is I add a tablespoon of paprika. That's the biggest ingredient in this. I add a teaspoon of several of the items here, garlic powder, onion powder, 2 teaspoons of date sugar. Now, most barbecue recipes call for brown sugar, but I bought some of this Anthony's Premium Date Sugar. It's non-GMO, gluten-free, and it's granulated. It looks a little different if you haven't ever seen date sugar before, but I use it instead of the brown sugar. And then I add a teaspoon of dry mustard, a teaspoon of chili powder. If you have smoked chili powder, it'll add a little richness to the flavor. 1/4 teaspoon of chipotle chili, which will give it some smokiness and also a little heat, and then a 1/4 teaspoon of cayenne, which also will give you some heat and flavor, and then 1/4 teaspoon of cumin, which I mostly use for the flavor. Now, I will tell you, instead of using 1 teaspoon of the garlic and 1 teaspoon of the onion powders, I put in a little extra just because I am a big fan of garlic and onion. But those are my main ingredients. I also am going to add just a touch of liquid smoke when I put this together and add it to the pan. I'm going to get this hot. Right as it's just about hot and it's ready to go, I'm going to add some barbecue sauce. Now, you can use whatever barbecue sauce you like. In the past, I've used some Dr. Pepper barbecue. I've used all kinds of traditional barbecues. I've used spicy barbecues. I've tried the low sugar barbecues or other things like that. I'm going to make my own barbecue sauce in the future and show you what that looks like. But for right now, I'm just going to use some store-bought jarred barbecue sauce that I'm going to mix in for flavor. If it becomes a little thick and gooey, you could add applesauce. You could just add water. You could add apple cider vinegar, something along those lines. But that's what I'm going to do. I've already mixed up my spice ingredients. If you'll notice, it's in one of my old pill bottles. You may have heard this before. There's a saying that goes like this: food is medicine. And there's a big quote. We're not really sure of the authorship of it. Some give it to a man that's often quoted in the plant-based community. But regardless, let food be thy medicine is a good principle. If we eat healthy, our bodies will be healthy for the most part. Now, there are things that can happen to your body that are outside of the realm of what you eat. But as far as we have control, we can control a lot of our health, get off of medicines like this one, by eating our healthy, whole food, plant-based meals. This is going to be a quick meal. I'm just going to take this seasoning and I'm going to sprinkle it on my jackfruit. I'll stir it all in, and I'm going to put a lot more than that, but I'm just showing you for the video here. I'll mix all this together. I'm going to throw it in my copper skillet that you saw, and I'm going to heat it up. While I'm doing that, I'm going to toast off a bun. I'm going to mix up the coleslaw with a little ranch dressing and vegan ranch, and it'll be good to go. I'll show you that in just 1 second. All right, I'm all through. So it looks like a barbecue. Looks like any other barbecue that you would get anywhere else. And basically what I did is I put the apples in the pan first, start them softening. I threw the jackfruit on top, spread it out evenly, and let it start cooking. And while I did that, I grabbed my seasoning, my rub, if you will, and I spread it evenly, a thin layer, all the way across the top. I had already added a little bit, just a touch of liquid smoke. I stirred it all up, I got it hot, and at the last minute, I added barbecue sauce. Now, you can add that in the pan, or you can add it in a bowl afterwards. The purpose of the barbecue sauce is a little bit of flavor, but it's also to make it hold together so it doesn't just fall off all over everywhere while you're eating it. But you could do all kinds of things with this. You could use this same recipe and make shredded potatoes. You could make cabbage with it. Whatever you want to do, there's a million ways in which you could eat this. But by taking some of that rub and taking those apples, putting it together, chopping up this jackfruit, it makes a barbecue sandwich. And so I have my whole wheat, whole grain buns here. And I'm just going to put some of this on a bun, and I'm going to put some of that cabbage on top, and I'll show you that in just a second. And again, you could make your coleslaw any way that you want to. I'm going to make this a big sandwich. All right, but put some of that barbecue on top. I'm going to take some of this cabbage that's got just a touch of ranch flavoring on it. You can either get it wet with apple cider vinegar and add dill weed and garlic to it, or you can just use a little bit of vegan ranch, put it on there. I'm gonna put a few dill pickles. I love dill pickles. I'm gonna put those on top. And here is my barbecue sandwich for a Saturday lunch. It is literally taken me to this point about 28 minutes to do this. So it's quick, it's easy, it tastes great. Mmm. Oh yeah. That's wonderful. If you want more flavor, kick up the spices. If you want more sauce, add more sauce. It's up to you. Do what you want. Normally, I wouldn't even use a recipe. I just throw all this together, add it while I'm cooking, stir it up, and eat it. But I did this for you so you guys would see kind of a basic rub. And you can modify it a bunch of different ways. This tastes great. I'm going to eat lunch. Less than 30 minutes. I'm done. Have a great day. My name's Denny. This is my plant-based journey. And there's more to come, including two recipes with pumpkin flavoring and pumpkin pie spice. I know. I know. We'll show you. My name's Denny. This is my plant-based journey. Have a great weekend.